We now have the very privilege and honor to call upon a very special Eirach that came specially for this Kinus. The Rebbe Shliach, Rosh Hashiva of Yeshivas Eir Al-Chanan Chabad in Los Angeles, California, Harav Shochet. We ask Rav Shochet to address us in English.
I don't have much to add to what was said, except maybe carry us down to a little lower level, because we have to deal with the lower level. We just read in the parsha that Moshe Rabbeinu asked, Lama reis, lama ze. And the content of the question, the pashtus, is that he was sent with the shlichas to tell them that the Gula is here, the Gula is coming, maybe he's going to take you out of Mitzrayim. And the Bnei Yisrael believed him. They had the Muna. And not only didn't the Gula happen, but it became worse. Pai made new gzeiros. They came with tainus. So that Moshe Rabbeinu was at fault, because he came and he spoke to Pari, and that just made Pari angry. And it's a chilul Hashem. That not only didn't, and we're talking about Eshlichus from the Eberster himself, through Moshe Rabbeinu himself, the Moshe Emes and Terasa Emes. And not only didn't it become better, but it became worse. And what did the Eberster answer him? Atasirin. So now you're going to see. That's okay, it's explained because the Golas had to become worse. The Eberster did a chesed instead of 400 years to make the Golas only 210 years. So it made a worse Golas in order to be able to shorten the Golas. How does that answer the Chilul Hashem? So said Moshe Rabbeinu, after the Golas become worse, make Pari make Xerius before Moshe Rabbeinu goes. Before Moshe Rabbeinu arouses the Emunah of all the Yidden, and all the Yidden are waiting, oh, now Moshe Rabbeinu came as a shliach from the Eberster himself, and the Gula is going to happen now. Let the Golas become worse, and then send Moshe Rabbeinu, so there won't be a Chilul Hashem. If the Golas, if the Eberster want to do a chesed, so why do you have to be with this Chilul Hashem? What's the answer to the Chilul Hashem over here? The human mind usually works. There's certain things I understand, there's certain things I don't understand. This is the way it's supposed to be. The Eberster can do whatever he wants, and that I understand. And when the Eberster wants to do something, and he sends a shliach Moshe Rabbeinu, it's supposed to happen exactly the way I understand it's supposed to happen. Golas Mitzrayim was supposed to be a preparation for Matan Torah. For Matan Torah, there is a gili of Anochi Avaya Lekech. The Eberster said, Shmi Havayi Lo Yadayti Lahem, that's a gilui that's only going to happen now. Is Nugilui something that even the Ovis didn't have the full Asoga in that? And Bamatan Teir was Amshocha of Atzmus and Sof, that the matter of Atzmus and Sof, Nidna Nimnois. Nidna Nimnois means that I don't have a description, I don't have a definition. It's something which is only by the Eibishter. And the Rebbe speaks in the Maimer 40 years ago, this concept 40 years ago and 60 years ago, that like this, people think that the union of Nimna Minoyes is Becheka Boiri, but it's not Becheka Nivroim. This has no connection with us. That's something which is only Atzmus Himself. But he says, you see, Mokam Orinenu Minamida. So you see, there is something over here in this world. And in my little world, where is that? In my little world, the Nimna Minoyes is there's a question that I don't have an answer. And Alphabet, everything is happening. God has a plan. I don't have to understand everything that God wants and how God does it. There has to be, sometimes there's a message that I don't understand that seems to be the opposite of everything the way it's supposed to be. And I'm full of frustration to the extent that even Moshe Rabbeinu has a question. And like the Rebbe explains that the reason Moshe Rabbeinu has a question and the others didn't have a question even though the Moshe Rabbeinu is on a higher madriga, because Moshe Rabbeinu lowered himself in order to be able to permeate by the Bnei Yisrael that even when there's questions, there's a Munah. Even when there's frustration, it doesn't change the fact. The ultimate frustration and the ultimate question that even a Benini of Tanya has, the Koshka V'Kavachayim, each one of us has, I worked. I came to a terrific Aviv and his battles. And the Eibishter b'shas atfilah through my Hezbonenus, where the Nefesh of Hamis was not there, disappeared totally. I felt only the Tamuru Kiteva Vayit, my Dveikus, my Achnus with the Eibishter. And it didn't come easy. I had to work hard for it. And I worked hard. At this moment of ultimate disallows. And davening finishes. He's back. Again, I have a taiva. It's the ultimate frustration. I'm working. I'm not giving in a single thing. I'm fighting. I'm battling. I'm doing everything I can. Not what Machshavah Dibur Mais was not the way to. Everything was the way it was supposed to be. I want to feel everything the way, how you feel when you're doing back on Kodesh Baruch, when you're connected with the Eibishter. I want to feel it. I want to be live that. That should be my whole life. And just go up from one level to another level. Yetzer is back. Titus are back. And he's frustrated. It's a frustration that the Alter Rebbe addresses in Tanya. And what's the answer? That's why you were created. When you have that frustration, I'm talking from my perspective, what I want, and there's something much higher. There's a Nachas Ruach the Eibishter has from a tzaddik of Tanya, the Mahapa Choshech Lo'er. And there's a Nachas Ruach that even though I have Yetzer Hara, and even though I have problems, and even though I have Choshech, and even though I have darkness, I still go ahead and do that what the Eibishter wants from me. Iskaf. It's a frustrating work. I tried once, I learned in Maimer, I had this Alus, I had this Aliyah for one month, the other month, and then all ones, and I fell. I did. I went to the Shlichas. I was Ma'iri the Moshe Rabbeinu Bekirbi. I believed everything that the Eibishter said, that I'm going to go and make the Gula Pratis. Then the Yetzer is back. There are certain things that we have to understand, that we do them only because I need a raise of the Shamash is kaining, not for my personal satisfaction. That's a yesod. That's a basis. It was mentioned over here something that the Rebbe wrote to me, personal letter. I'll make a little fool of myself, but maybe it's kedai for the inyan. When I was a young kid, 13, 14, a little bit of an egomaniac. And besides being egomaniac, I also had the regular problems that every teenager has. And there was one Purim that Nichnas Yain Yotzei. So I wrote a letter to the Rebbe from Aleph to Tov, everything that's going on with me. And I wrote all my Ruchnisdike problems, my Ruchnisdike Yuridis, and the Nishenis that a teenager has, and Chuli Chuli, and what I do about it, and what the. And one of my other problems was that the Ivert Egomania comes in. That they say the Alter Rebbe wrote the Shulchan Aruch when he was 18, 20, started writing, wrote Hilchos Sittes, Hilchos Pesach. Shav Shmeitzer wrote the Shav Shmeitzer when he was 18. Meshulam Iker when he was 13, he said it Roshi, that all the Gedei Lo'elam and he spoiled, etc., etc. He said, I can't do that. Even if I sit and learn. So, since I can't do it, so what's it worth? So this was the answer to Rabbi Teichen. I don't remember the exact clause. Regarding all the problems that you're writing, I'm sure you have a Tanya with a Mafteich and Yonim, but over there you find an answer to every one of your problems. And Mafteich and Yonim will make it easier to find it. That was regarding all the spiritual problems. Regarding my egomaniac, the Rebbe wrote over here, Holer Riches. Es wundert sich mir dein ganzes Stell. I don't understand. I was a young kid still, but that's what the way the Rebbe wrote it. Es wundert sich mir dein ganzes Stell. Is the purpose of a Jew bigger than another Jew to become the greatest? If the Eibusha wants one person to be big in learning, so he'll give him the ability for that. If he wants another person to be big in stock, he'll give him the ability for that. Everyone with his particular shlichus, he has those abilities that the Eibusha gave him. And Kaidois, the purpose of a Mishnah is Kaidois HaMishnah Anina Vesi L'Shamash Eskain. I was created to serve a master for the shlichus that the Eibusha sent me down in this world. What kind of approach do you have over here? Now the Rebbe added another line, just so because he probably knew me the way my mind might work. Selbstverständlich, this is only talking about Hadofe, Zoris Tvei. But everybody is Mukhuyi Bechol Tayag Mitzvah, the Talmud Teiru Keneged Kulam. I won't be the biggest, I might stop learning, but that's not my tafki. So the Rebbe add that line also. So there is frustrations. There's wants of mitzad, what's called my yeshus, or there's wants with mitzad, my character, there's wants with mitzad, or whatever, how I set my goals, etc. And I don't seem to be even living up to these goals. Chassidus brings out this point. This is one of the main emphasis of this point. Bnei B'chayri Yisrael, Kana Yisrael Ve'eveyu, like the Rebbe connects these two things. There's the revelation of the built-up attributes that he attains through his hard work. And there's those things where he's not Metzliach, he's an Ara. And dafka over there comes the Ava Atzmus of the Eibishter. The Eibishter wants a Yid. And he loves a Yid because he's a Yid. And he gave every Yid an opportunity to do something. Is there frustration? The frustrations are part of the shlichas that I have over here from the Eibishter. Because nachas ruach lebayim. But still, some come along and say, I want to feel good about myself. So let's take a look. It's a good question. I want to feel good about myself. I want to be besimcha. So before Rabbi Yael already answered and brought out some points from a letter and a mimer, I'm going to say it in a little bit different words, maybe at a lower level. Tanya starts off with two questions. That's how Tanya starts off. That's the psiche about everything starts off with that, which obviously over there is the whole thing, what it's all about. He asks a contradiction. It's a contradiction. But then he asks a logical question. Which shows right away the importance that you have to have a question on a Maimah Chazal, on a Gemara, because I can't serve the Eivishter B'simcha Tuv Leivov. So right away, he puts down the Yesod, he puts down the foundation. How important Simcha Tuv Leivov is. And if I'm in my eyes like a Rosh, lo yuchal avad Hashem B'simcha Tuv Leivov. If the fact that I'm a Rosha and I have all these frustrations and I do all these things, I'm not going to feel bad about it. Like attitude of some, don't worry about it. That's you. You know, the Rebbe is always Zoyer B'Lashayna. He's always very careful. There was nobody that was Zoyer B'Lashayna Nekiyo and not to call names like the Rebbe. Even when it comes to things, I say, Hepech HaChayim, Hepech HaTev, always Zoyer B'Lashayna. There's one letter where the Rebbe writes, V'lei kedas reifa elilim. I don't know how to translate that in English, except for maybe witch doctors. That say, don't worry about it, feel good about yourself. When it comes to certain titles. And if you're medayin the lashon over here in Tanya, v'im lo yeir levove klal mezeh yochel lovin l'day kalus chas v'sholem. Now, we know simcha is the yesod, but over there, lo yuchel av l'shem simcha tuv levove, doesn't write chas v'sholem. When it comes to kalus, he writes chas v'sholem. So it's also something that we have to think about. So here's a question. So when it comes to the stira, so we all know the answer. So he gives in Tanya. It's talking about, it's not, when it says, it doesn't really mean a Rosh. It means Kerosh, it means a Beinani. Okay, so a Beinani has a Mahalach B'chayim. Fine. And it's only Kerosh, and therefore it's not a stira to Simcha, because it's serving the Eivishter. Although it might not be an answer to his frustration, that's the other answer. But the second question, the logical question, that's a question for me. I'm not a Beinani. I'm not. Once upon a time, Chassidim said, Halavai Beinani. Nowadays, you got to say Halavai Rosh HaVetevla sometimes. Why? Because the difference between Rosh HaVetevla and Rosh HaVetevla, Rosh HaVetevla doesn't have a Hira Tshuva when he does wrong. Rosh HaVetevla has a Hira Tshuva when he does wrong. So, somebody like me, when I take this logical question, the second question of the beginning of Tanya, how should I look at myself? If I think about my weaknesses and about the Rosh, so how am I going to say the Eivishter B'simcha Tuv Leivov? If I'm going to just ignore it, lo yeir levov v'klal mizeh, say nachbal etzlan, things will become worse. Yochel lovei day kalus chas v'sholem. So what's my advice? So on that, the Rebbe Tzeichen Su, but the answer to this is Periglamid Aleph and Periglamid Gimel. What does he say over there? Shloile Arif ulevalve simchis ha-nefesh ba'atzmin ha-guf. I have to know what my goof is, I have to know what my nefesh ha-bahamis is. But just like I have a goof and I have a nefesh ha-bahamis, I also have a nefesh ha-lekis. And mitzad the nefesh ha-lekis, even though that my goof and nefesh ha-bahamis might be very disgusting, my nefesh ha-lekis is a chelik elekai mimal mamish. And that I have to attach myself and think and connect myself with the simcha of the nefesh ha-lekis. And that is what simcha is. That's what Rabbi was talking about. Don't let the Yetzer Hara, the Nefesh HaBahamis, the Guf, convince you that this is what I'm about. I have a Guf and a Nefesh HaBahamis. And I have work with the Guf and the Nefesh HaBahamis. And the work with the Nefesh HaLakis has to try to overcome it. And that's the Nachas work for the Eibishter. The Iskafia Sitriach. And that's how we're mamshit. And I have to relate. So not chas v'shalom that I'm going to be happy that I'm a bal taiva. My happiness is that there is a nefesh elokis, and this nefesh elokis is always b'omno itay yisbarach. And because of this nefesh elokis, even if Rachman Litzlan, somebody is a kal shebekalim, etc., that Kalim Kalim Akal, that he's all the way gone. He's still Alpi Reif is Moses Nafshal Hashem. You know, the ultimate frustration could come. I mean, let's take Tanya over here. Tanya Sefer Shabbat. Benjamin is supposed to be Midas Kolod. Supposed to be the what everybody is supposed to strive for, the Benjamin of Tanya. That every Machshov and Dibur and Maisa in Echnami cannot get changed and transformed into the Nefesh HaBahamis. He can't transform the essence of the Nefesh HaBahamis, but the Machshov and Dibur and Maisa, he can control. That's in my control. And that's what everybody is supposed to strive for. That's my goal. It's Midas Kolod. In Tanya itself, Halevaye Beni Sho Achas Meshach Yimei Chayev. Berek Chof Zayin. That if somebody is sad because he has Machshava's voice, and that comes to him, he said it comes from Gaiva. Because you're not properly evaluating yourself. Halevaye Beni Sho Achas Meshach Yimei Chayev. And even by a Beni, it's Machshav, that's his work. These Machshavas come to him, these Taivas come to him, this fight is there by him. That's what the fight of the Beni is all about. And in the face of Shamash is going. And I'm me, Halavayi Beni. So what are you sad about? That's the Shlichas that you have over here in this world, to have this darkness, to have this question, to have this Taiva, to have this hardship, and overcome it. But there's frustration over here. I'm supposed to strive. Everybody strives. There's a natural inclination over here. I want to reach the goal. And in Tanya itself, it says, Halavayi Beni Sho Achas. Meshach, one moment in your entire lifetime. How in the world am I going to come and get to satisfaction? Over here is also the same point. Leila Arif Ulevalbel Simchas HaNefesh Ba'atzmin HaGuf. This is packed in Tanya. Just because I am that what I am with my weaknesses, and I have a fight on my hands, I have to know that the more fight I have in my hands, the more nachas ruach I'm going to bring to the Eibishter if I do what I'm supposed to do, and that is supposed to be my simcha. Am I supposed to just ignore my responsibilities or what I'm supposed to be or where I'm supposed to be just to be able to feel good? Let's take a look. Tanya, the Eitzah, that he, in Tanya Perek Aleph, right, he starts off. How does he start off Perek Aleph? That what is a Rosh, what is a Benoni? So he says, and he brings the Maimah Chazal, Komi She'efshri, Lassim, Tevein, Oesik, Sholav, Dorsh, Rizali, Chorus to Chorus, for sure you're a Rosh. For sure. And Chazal say, from the, and it's mentioned also, from the Shleish Aveir, Sheinod, Nitzel, Membechol, Yev, one of them is Bittel Tevein. So he starts off in a Perek Aleph of Tanya. Kol mi she'efshar la'asik b'teir v'eino oisek. It's for sure called a Rosh. With the koshken ha'kal v'chaim, a Rosh is the koshken ha'kal v'chaim. And the Chazal say, eino b'nitzel menu kol yei. Where is my simcha supposed to come from? Or well, how is it that I'm going to be able to strive and go, I'll be frustrated, I won't be able to reach? If I'm looking for my own satisfaction, for my own perfection, there's no answer. If I realize, Loi ani burozis atzmi, I didn't create myself. And the same Eivish that created Nefesh al-Kis, the same Eivish that created also Nefesh al-Bamis. And the same Eivish that wants, just like he wants Teiv Bo'ilom, he also wants this, one of the ways of transforming this world, there should be a dear Lo Yisburach B'tachtoinim, is through Iskafil. That way it comes through me. And then there's something that the Eivish is going to be mashing, the Eivish is going to help. There is something that I have to realize that goes way beyond human comprehension. The Simchas HaNefesh, the Nefesh of the Keys, the Nachas Ruach LeBeirei, Shamayti V'Nasi Ritzeini. And that's what the Maimer Chassidus brings out, this Reichkeit. Nothing else can bring this out. Nothing else brings it out. It's an approach. But then there's still that little voice in me. But all this frustration, what it's doing to me. And if I can get a quick fix, why shouldn't I get a quick fix? So I can feel good about myself, it's so important. Let me ask you a simple question. Let's make an honest evaluation. And in Geres HaKodesh Simen Chof Hei, he speaks about Kol HaKodesh Kilo Eved Avodah Zarah. Because everything that happens in this world happens only from the Eibishter. See, even if somebody, Rachmon Litzlan, Mamish, was mazik you, damaged you, hurt you, he did something really bad. Not as a kas, I'm a duma because I imagined something. He talked it bad. Still, kol hakoyes kilo eved avodah zarah. Why? Because nothing happens to me without the Eivishter being goyse. It comes from the Eivishter. That's why I'm angry at him, even though that he has a problem with his bechira, and that's why it went through him. But what I'm angry not because of what he did, because of himself, because of his avodah. I'm angry because of what happened to me. So that came from the Eivishter. His brothers. And therefore, what happened to me is something that has to do with me. I have to make my own calculation. Why did this happen to me? It has nothing to do with him. And if I get angry at him, that means that I'm not recognizing this truth. And that's why it's called the disorder. So here is a simple Hisbonanus that when something irritates me, for a real good reason, And his bonus that Tanya gives you of not getting angry. Then in the world there is ways, etc. When a person gets angry, so think into it. Why are you getting angry? For what are you getting angry? Is it real, the anger? Is there a real reason for the anger? Or is it only outside circumstances that are causing your anger? And it makes me realize all at once how I should be able to control my anger. Oh, I finally got an answer for my anger. I'm a person that gets angry and irritated very easily. I got an answer for my anger. Why does that Eitze help any more than what it says in Tanya? Let's be honest. Let's make an honest evaluation over here. Why is that helping more than what it says in Tanya? So the only difference that I can find is that according to the way it says and the way the world goes about it, etc., so what's happening over there, I have my rights. Except, since I'm a human being, I can make mistakes. I shouldn't have gotten angry. But I still have my rights of getting angry. There's still certain things I can get angry about. When it comes to Tanya, so if you hear all at once, I'm losing my rights. That I don't want to do. Where does that lead to? And where does that go to? When you have something that's only on what I feel, what I am, my right, my individuality, taking out the denominator that my main essence, my main power, my main identity, my main source of simcha is Ahava Shlichus from the Eibishter himself. My ultimate level that I can reach is that for the creator of the whole world, I can do something, Kabiyoch. If you don't have that approach, so then Rachmon Litzlan, or you see it, if we want to deal with practicality and what be real, or the other words you might want to use, so then Rachmon Litzlan, there's a big question over here, am I not denying the whole basis of the very foundation of what Chassidus is all about? What is the basis, one of the main ikri that Chassidus came to carry down so that everybody should be able to relate to it, have a certain understanding in it, live with it? The concept of Achdus Havayah. Ein Oid Muvad. And although that there's a world, and it's not a steer, because everything the Eibishter created for that purpose that he wants to create it, he's not separated from it. And there's Ashkocha Protis, and nothing happens without the Eibishter wanting it. And this Ashkocha Protis goes so far, that even Rachmon Litzlan, when somebody falls, it is also Ashkocha, so you should be able to come to even a higher Madrid. Not this Pchir Berach, as we show. That's the person's power. So those are from the very fundamental, basic concepts of Emunah that Chassidus teaches us. Over here, we seem to have the ultimate contradiction and frustration possible, although Chassidus speaks about it. But if I have this attitude, I want to be real, and I want to go with what I feel, and I want to have something, so that Olam is Melhelim Behest. That it's impossible to be able to live with the concept of Ein Oid Mavadoi, of Ashkocha Protis, in every single detail and prat. And that I am here, and I am living, and I'm functioning, and I'm doing something only because the Eibishter is the Mechayes Kula. And it's giving me Chayes right now. It's a total contradiction to the very basic concept of what Chassidus came to teach the world, of what the Baal Shem Tov came to be Mechadish. And the world is not a separate entity. Although the world is an entity. It's like the Rebbe explains in many Maimonides and Sichas. But still, it's not a separate entity. Because everything has that the chayas of the Eibishter and that purpose which the Eibishter wants it, even klipin sitrach. Kamoshla Zeya, you do it, it's also brought in time. So when somebody goes away, chas v'shalom, from the approach of chassidus, and goes away from this concept that I have a nefesh hakiyus, and I have a shlichus and a nefesh, and that everything has a purpose, and that purpose is I should be able to overcome it. And yes, the mitzorim and the gvulim and the ra, although we don't understand it. The Rebbe once expressed himself by Verbrengen with Dmoy Sholish about the Holocaust, that he doesn't want to understand it. He doesn't want to bring it down to humans. It should be taka mufrach. But that's not a contradiction to the total emunah that everything comes from the Eibishter. And that the Eibishter has a purpose. And ani hakotanim also within that purpose. Not only ani hakotanim in that purpose, but that letter the Rabbi Yael read before. But the Rebbe quotes, and this is something that the Rebbe demanded from kids before bar mitzvah. That as far as I am concerned, it's b'shvili nivra oila. And the Eibush is maniach el yayinim et achtayinim, all the higher worlds and all the lower worlds and everything. Umabit olam b'yichin kloyis v'leiv, that every single machshava dibra maizis negayet him. Together with my nefesh of Amis and Yetzahor. Together with my limitations. And that's how I have to look myself. And that's when I have the opportunity, who am I and what am I? What merit do I have that I should be able to understand? Just to be able to understand these words in church. What merit do I have? To be able to have a yichud chain, yichud itmos and imsa cloud. That can put on tefillin, l'shabdis, aleivet, amoyach. What did I do to earn that? I merited to be a Ben Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, and to be a Yisrael with all the avot that the Eibishter has to Yisrael and gives him this opportunity, and that I can bring about a Nachas Ruach HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So I have to look for another eight. When we're talking about Bittul and all this, and that somehow the world doesn't like to accept it so much. I have to be an entity, otherwise how am I going to function? The bittul is the ultimate yesh. Because it's only true yesh, my connection with the Eibishter. Everything else is only a dinyan, even though it's a reality. But the reality of it is only when it functions in the purpose which the Eibishter created it. Let's go back a little bit. When I was a 13, 14-year-old, the Rebbe wrote me, you have a Tanya, I'm sure you have a Mefteach in Yoni, which will make it much easier to find the answers. We didn't have the Biurim of the Rebbe at that time. We didn't have Tanya in Yiddish at that time. We didn't have look at the Sikha 39 Krochim, Teres Menachem, who knows how many Krochim. We didn't have the Memorial of the Rebbe, and we didn't have the Igor's Kodesh, where over there in the Mafteich and Yodim you can find Eitzes, the Chol, Nega, Upega that somebody has in their daily life. I want to finish off. It's a known word, and it says it's for it. And basically, I don't have to quote from it. Let's just take simply, again, one of the psukim, Amori Chazal, that they ever wanted little kids to chazer. You guide them, lo yimitzasi all the time. Lo yigayit yimitzasi all the time. You guide them, it's also time. Kedusha. To be able to be part of it, it can't come for free. to be able to be one, to be able to get into this hagosha of avishliches that I can make a nachas ruach lebayri, it can't come by itself. So it says in Sforim that one of the simonim, whether something is coming from the Yetzer Hara, the Yetzer Tov, if something comes very easy, you have big question marks. Where is this coming from? If my whole yegiyah is only a physical yegiyah, it's not a real horavanya, which takes through the person, where is this coming from? Or let me ask it in different words. Let's say it's taka a very strong yegiyah. Why for this yegiyah am I ready? And this yegiyah, the old-fashioned chassidish yegiyah, to harve and understand the maim chassidus, to understand the suki and the gemara, to understand the tesis, to understand the machlekes rishonim, to understand the swar of the chayim, to understand the sikh of the rebbe properly with the maim chayimis. Why this yegiyah pulls me and this yegiyah to find the eights of this? Not for me. That in itself is the ultimate proof. The natural draw of Olam Hazeh is a natural draw. It's a tangible draw. Anything that's tangible in my tangible world, that is not Kedusha. Let me say it in different words if you don't believe me. Let's take this Maimer Chazal in itself. Let's talk to a little kid that's 8 years old. That's who ever said it, right? The guy took Leim Etzos. The kid worked hard, learned the whole night on the test. And he got a 40 on the test. So what do you mean all the time? It's a fact. I worked hard. I got a 40. Loi Gaiti Metzos, your kid has a good head. Didn't learn a whole week, crammed the last second for 15 minutes, and he got 100 on the test. Happens all the time. Happens all the time. Lo yigaiti mitzasi, what do you mean all the time? And then yigaiti mitzasi timing. What's the... In all of them, what's the lotion timing? All timing, over here, timing. What happened over here? He worked hard, he got a good mark, more than he expected. So I timing, so he sees it. He didn't get a good mark, so I'm going to believe in something which is against the fact. We're talking about an 8-year-old kid. So over here, you're going to say this 8-year-old kid won't relate to what I'm going to say now. So let's take one more Maim Chazal that the Rebbe demanded from 8-year-old kids. In the psukim, right? There's six psukim. And there's two psukim from Teresh B'Ksav, two from Teresh B'Alpeh, and then two from Tanya. The first six and the same in the last six. So when he picks from Tanya in the last six, the last one, Yismach Yisrael, Yisrael, Pirish, Yisrael, 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 Yisrael. Okay, brought in Simcha. Simcha is a very big Yisrael. They wanted our kids to grow up with the concept of Simcha. There's many quotations of Simcha. I mean, I just quoted before, L'yichol Av L'Hashem V'Simcha is, I mean, there's more than Peg Chavov. Two people that are struggling. If one is atzus bekvedus, he can't win. You have to be besimcha. So there's other places where he brings out the concept of simcha. What did he pick for an 8-year-old kid? The concept of simcha. Yismach Yisrael b'Oisav pirish yakol mi shehu mezera Yisrael. That anybody that is mezera Yisrael, anybody that's a Jew because he happened to be born a Jew. Not that I worked on it. Yeshua l'smoyach. I'm just translating the words. He has to be happy. B'simchas Hashem. My happiness is what? Not because I got the good candy. Not because I got a terrific mark and I got a big pat on the shoulder. Not because I accomplished. Not because I reached. But B'simchas Hashem. That's the simcha of an 8-year-old. And that's what the Rebbe said, that every 8-year-old should chazen. In other words, that everything that we're talking about relating to the Eibishter, I have a shlichus on the Eibishter, and that I'm doing something for the Eibishter, and I'm actually making a simcha for the Eibishter, and that is my ultimate simcha, is something that even an 8-year-old can relate to. The Rebbe was practical. How? When we have problems. Of course we have problems, because we're not relating. We're not thinking into what it says in Tanya about Nagov. Because we try to relate to only that what our natural external thing being says. We don't have the basic emunah. Chas v'shalom, we have, but I'm just, it's just figurative speech, sorry. By Yigaita Mitzosi, there's many sikhas in the Rebbe, and the Rebbe explains. When I'm talking about Mitzosi, we're not talking about what the human mind comprehends. Learning a Mishnah, learning a Pasuk Chumash, learning a Rashi, learning a Taisvitz, learning a Maimach Sidis is not Chas V'Sholem learning a subject. It's not just another wisdom. But by Yid, it's something much more, like it says in simple words. It's a yichud she'engeg mosa nim zeklau. I grasp chochmosa yizbarach. And Nigla, what Nigla brings down, and it's what Chassidus brings down, the ultimate unity with the Eibush. Like Rebbe explains, the Dal V'Shem Yishagulut, that the ultimate, Rulakachli, it's limit primis atayr. The Gauti is limit Nigla. And V'Lakachli, that's limit primis atayr. That's how the Eibishter takes me. That's how I have my gula. Because that's how I relate. That's how I get. So the Mitzosi is something that goes way beyond human comprehension. It's a Mitzia. That's Kedusha. That's Avodas Hashem. That's a mitzvah. That's what learning Torah is about. That's what Chassidus comes and brings out so that everybody should be in a way that everybody should be able to relate to it. And the Rebbe says an 8-year-old kid can understand. It's only a guy to Mitzosi. That's how I get Kedusha. When I harvest in this, to acquire this meter teva, to learn this part of teva, to daven with a little bit of kavana, so I zeche to something of a hiskashus and hisachdus, which nothing else can bring me. And I start relating to understand what simchas hanefesh is, what the simcha of nefesh and the kis is all about. But the Nachas Ruach Lefonish Almighty, that there is such a thing that means something to me. So yes, it takes a reminder. And yes, sometimes it's very true. Sometimes we need Tanya Perek Choftes, or Geres HaTshuva Perek Zayin, or the simple, the old-fashioned way that by Krishna Shalamita we should make some kind of a cheshbon ha-nefesh, and to make a cheshbon of how the day passed by, and how much I utilized my day. And how much of my abilities did I really bring forth? You know, one of the things, one of the pizgamim of the Rebbe, the Rebbe has it. Printed in certain places. So let go of the Ra, say Toiv, involve yourself in Toiv. Another piskun that the Rebbe said that say kochen sich in Al-Ched, mir kochen sich in Besimlech. The whole derech of Chassidus was don't give the Ra such a mitzvah. Involve yourself in thinking and doing in horving, in learning, in davening, in avos yisrael, in chesed, and automatically you won't be bothered. A problem a lot by today's youth is that they don't want to believe this. And maybe by today's human life. They're obsessed, rachman al-islam. I did this, I did this, I did that, and the whole melchama isn't the sumira. And that Muhammad is Sumer Rav, Chamon Litzlan, comes about to such a thing where it puts them down or breaks them, and that this is not talking to me and it can't talk to me. The basis for all that is there's a very bad mistake being made by a lot of kids. When I say Atar B'chatonim Mekol Ha'am, what am I talking about? A goy that's a noyev, a goy that's a ganev, a goy that's a ramai, a goy that's oyved avay dezor. What am I talking about? Or I say Atar B'chatonim Mekol Ha'am, even if somebody is chassidi u'mesayil. He's mekayim le'sinov, he's mekayim le'signov, he's mekayim le'sirtzach. And he's mekayim at all because of Tzivu Hashem. But we are something totally different. That's what Chassidus brings out. And we can kochzich in this different. We have nimud ha'Torah. We have kiyum ha'mitzvahs. We have a gisa b'yayim ha'balayla. Get involved! And when you get involved, so then automatically those other things will just become fall on the wayside. Maybe, I mean, let's be honest. We all live in the Sichon Chof Ches Nissen. I mean, the Rebbe said, Rebbe Shizkim, I want Mashiach now, not because the Rebbe said it, but because I want it. Because I talk I want it. And the Rebbe said that if three, or maybe even one, will say it because he wants it, that's it. What's the meaning of I want Mashiach now? How did the Rebbe explain it? Can think, I am who I am, and I want everything to just disappear. And live in the perfect world. Maybe that's a good thing. But that's a falsehood. You don't want that perfect world, you just want to get rid of your hardships. I want Mashiach now means that I try to daven. I try to really speak today, but with all my horvani, it's limited. I want Mashiach now. I try to learn, I horv in the sugya, or I horv in a maimer, and it's just not light in my head. I want Mashiach now. I have frustrations. I want to be a good shliach of the Eibishter. I want to be a good shliach of the Rebbe. I want to do everything that's wanted. I'm trying. I'm falling. The frustration of the Beinoni. I want Mashiach now. I want it so that what I'm involved in should really be the way it's supposed to be. Not that I should be able to stop being involved and stop working. The Rebbe said, Limud HaChassidus, the Mashiach himself said, Kshiyafutza Manasecha Chutzo, so Limud HaChassidus, Avodas HaChassidus, Afotas HaChassidus, that's what's going to bring him. Has to start with ourselves, that we should know what this is all about. There is a cheshkes agolus, and it's very dark. And we need Mashiach. Let's get involved in chassidus so that when I say I want Mashiach now, I take a want him for what he's about. That the Rebbe put it in the simple word, Shleimus HaTorah Mitzvah. Chassidim zayn klug, chassidim zayn shtark. We're not going with our own koiches, we're going with the koiches that the Rebbe gave us, that the Rebbe is giving us. Let's just just start to relate to reality, not to the falsehoods of Elam Hazeh, and not to the all the different types of ways that is that are drawing us. And maybe the positive aspect is, like Rabbi Yael started off, that this whole issue and why this meeting was called together, is that's the first positive aspect, that this meeting was called together, should happen more often. We should come together, strengthen each other. This was called because it became known that there is a terrific bikush. People are lost. People are looking. People want to find. People want to be right. People don't want to be wrong. So I'll finish off with this halach in the Rambam, and there's a sikh from the Rebbe about it. That Mishen Roy Lehro Meire calls him all kinds of names. Rabbim Chloe Hippilum, it causes all kinds of death. In the same halach, and I never understood, in the same halach, Umish Roy Lehro Ve'ena Meire, and him it says, Atsubim Kolay Rugel. Maybe even a worse. There's a bikush. When the Rebbe said that if you know an aleph, teach an aleph, you know a beis, teach a beis, the Rebbe was not only talking about the word at large. And hilchos toke kol korev korev koidu. We have to set up shurim. We have to feel the responsibility. We have to be mekayev b'avuzis ava, everybody. Anybody that has answers should be always ready to answer. Because people are looking. Don't let them fall into the hands of those that which will kill them. But the only way that can happen, and this is a sikha from the Rebbe, is that those that are royal, and you have something to teach, because you learned the sikha, you can share that sikha. So those that are royal are moirim. Because it's totally zeb and zeb. It's dependent on one another. Let's do our job. Let's have hope that we'll do it the way the Rebbe wants us to do it. So we'll have all the brachas in the Rebbe. And we'll be zeicher to be chassidim the way we're supposed to be. We'll be zeicher to the gula shleim v'kol.